Like thin ice on a pond, the brittle lithosphere is broken into segments called plates. The modern lithosphere is fractured into 7 major plates and several minor ones. The plates move by floating horizontally over the soft, plastic asthenosphere. Today, these plates are moving at rates between 1 and 20 centimeters per year in the directions shown by the arrows. Where any two plates meet, their motions cause them to bump and grind together at their boundaries. As a result, most earthquakes, volcanoes, and mountain ranges concentrate at the plate boundaries. As the plates move horizontally, floating over the asthenosphere, they move in different relative directions where two plates meet. In some places, two plates spread apart from one another. This kind of plate boundary is called a spreading center. At a spreading center, new lithosphere forms as hot asthenosphere rock rises to fill the gap left by the separating plates. Some of the hot asthenosphere melts as it rises, forming basalt magma. Most of this magma rises to the surface to form new oceanic crust. The new lithosphere at the spreading center is hot and therefore of low density. Because of its low density, it floats to a higher level than the surrounding seafloor, forming a mid-oceanic ridge. As the oceanic crust separates, blocks of rock slip downward, forming a rift valley in the center of the mid-oceanic ridge. Beneath the seas, the mid-oceanic ridge circles the Earth for 80,000 kilometers. It's the longest, largest mountain chain on Earth. As new lithosphere spreads outward from a spreading center, equal amounts of old lithosphere disappear by sinking into the mantle at a subduction zone. Here, where two plates collide, one dives into the mantle beneath the other. The diving plate drags part of the seafloor down with it, forming an oceanic trench. Trenches are the deepest parts of the seas, reaching depths of more than 10 kilometers. Great quantities of basaltic magma form in a subduction zone. The magma rises to erupt onto the sea floor. It forms volcanoes that eventually rise above sea level to create an island arc. Frequent earthquakes occur in the subduction zone, where the diving plate scrapes and jerks its way down into the mantle. Island arcs formed in this way are abundant in the southwestern Pacific Ocean, where subduction is occurring today, and volcanic eruptions are common. Subduction can also bring a diving plate beneath the edge of a continent. Basaltic magma forms here too, but something different happens when it rises into the base of the continent. Continents are made of granite. Basalt magma is hundreds of degrees hotter than the temperature at which granite melts. Therefore, when the basalt magma rises into the base of the continent, it melts the granite, forming huge amounts of granite magma. The granite magma then rises and solidifies higher in the crust to form great granite plutons. The addition of so much magma and heat causes the crust to swell and thicken, forming a great mountain chain above the subduction zone. The mountains erode as they rise. Eventually, the granite plutons are exposed at the Earth's surface,